Welcome to My Clark ctcLink. Today we are going to walk through how to run a PeopleSoft query. You can run queries in all three of the pillars. Today we're going to focus on campus solutions. When you click into the pillar that you have access to on the top, then you will come to the nav bar. That's this little circle with the diamond in it. Click on the nav bar, go to Navigator, and your navigation path is going to be going down to probably close to the bottom of what you have, and you're going to go to Reporting Tools. Click on Reporting Tools, and you're going to then click on Query and Query Viewer. Once you have Query Viewer, if you know the name of the query that you want, you can simply type that query in and click Search. You will then see in the list of queries, this is the query that I searched for. I have a couple of options. I can run it to HTML so that I can view it on my screen. If I'm certain this is what I'm looking for and I need to save it in an Excel file, I can save it directly to Excel. I can run it as an XLM file. Or if it's a really large query, I may need to schedule it in order to give it enough time to process. I'm going to run this to HTML so that you can see this process. It will pop up a screen with whatever fields you are allowed to filter by. First, you want to filter by the institution. Clark College is WA 140. And then this is a financial aid list, and so it wants aid year. So financial aid year is 2021. And then click on View Results. You can see that it is processing when it has the little circle spinning. Depending on the amount of data that you are looking at, it may take a couple of seconds. And here we have the results. Once I have these results, I see the first 1 through 38 of 38. If there were additional rows, I might see 1 through 38 of 500, and I would be able to continue to click through. You can always go to the last record or the first record. From here, if I choose to, I can then save it into an Excel spreadsheet, or a CSV text file, or an XML file. I'm going to save it to an Excel spreadsheet. You'll note that it brings up the file down here, and from here, I can open it or I can save it. I'm going to open it so that I'm able to view my results, and then I can do a file save as and save it wherever I would like to. Please note that when you are saving Excel files with student or employee information, you should not save these to your hard drive. They should be saved to a secure shared space. When you are done with this query, you can simply X out and you return. I am now going to show you a couple of other things. If you like this query, you thought that was a great query, I'm going to run that regularly, you can click on Favorite and it will add it to your favorites. So the next time you come in, you will see here it is. So these are queries that I have saved to Favorite. And anytime I want to, I can come in and I can run these queries and I don't even have to use the information up above to search. So I'm going to open up this query, institution WA 140, term. I'm going to click on here and I'm going to find the correct term that I want. So I want fall 2020. So that term number is 2207, but you don't have to remember that because you can always use the lookup to be able to find that. Academic group, or I can leave it blank. I'm going to go ahead and put one in so this will run a little bit quicker. I can put in an academic org, or I can leave it blank. Again, I can select from this list. I'll go ahead and leave that blank. And then I have the option of a class status. Perhaps I want to look at all the canceled sections. Click on View Results and it provides me with all of the information. X out of there, and I can return. Now, sometimes you don't know what the name of a query is. You can click on this advanced search, and you have some options. So you have a query name, and you can put in what it begins with. Many of the queries start with a Q, and then CS for campus solutions. So I could narrow down my list that way. Search, and it will bring up all the campus solutions queries. There are more than 300. You will only display 300 here. Up here, you will receive a message. Too many items met your search criteria. Only the first 300 items are displayed. And you will note here you only see 300. So I'm going to narrow it down a little bit more. And you have options. Description begins with, or change it to contains. And so let's say I want to look for something that has to do with FTEs. I can now search. And I'm in Campus Solution looking for something that uses FTEs. And here's an interesting one, FTEs and headcount by student group. So I will go ahead and click on HTML, enter WA140 for my institution, term 2207. I want to look at fall. I'm going to leave group name blank so you can see what happens. It highlights it in red and tells me this is a required field, so I must enter this. So I come back because I don't know what the group name is. I come back and I see this list of groups, and so I want to look at Running Start Admissions. Now I can click on View Results, and I will see all the information. There are other things you can search for when you become much more familiar with PeopleSoft. You can search for particular record names or field names. You can also search within a particular folder. So if you know that you're looking for something within the admissions folder. So now I have QCS and admissions, and it's going to use this as an and provide you everything that meets that criteria of having both of those. If I were to remove the QCS and just run everything in admissions, so there were 18 queries there, run it without the QCS, and I'm up to 24. You'll see this includes some other queries. 170, that means that is a query from another college, the 170 college. There are some CTC queries that were originally developed in the initial process, and then the remaining QCS queries. Owner is always going to be public. There are no private queries that are allowed. Please note that in order to run a query, you must have a role that gives you access to the query reviewer in whichever pillar you are wanting to view a query in. And then you need to have access to the data that's contained in that query. That information is grouped together. So for example, in this admissions folder, you need access to the admissions query. There are also roles that give you access to highly sensitive student data, like social security number, or that information is only provided to a select few people who need that information. If you do not have access to that role, then you are not going to be able to run a query that requires that information.